St. Paul tells us that Jesus Christ comes to us in his mystical body, the church. He comes to us individually and personally in the sacraments of the church, the seven sacraments of the church. In this program, we are going to look into those sacraments.
God's Magnificent Seven, Reflections on the Seven Sacraments, written and read by Father Charles E. Irvin.
Hello, my name is Father Charles Irvin, priest of the Diocese of Lansing, Michigan. We're here in Milwaukee at the Basilica of St. Josaphat, beautiful, beautiful church. Jesus Christ comes to us in his mystical body, the church, particularly in his sacraments. Baptism is the primary sacrament in which Jesus Christ joins us into himself. Together with the sacraments of confirmation and Holy Eucharist, we are initiated into him as well as into the life of his Father and the Holy Spirit. He remembers us into his being, into who he is, into what he is doing to accomplish his Father's project in creating us in the first place. When we are baptized into Christ. We become a part of him. We enter into his life, into all that he is, into his passion, his death, and his resurrection. We are joined into his humanity, and in so doing, during the rite of baptism, the priest prays, "By the mystery of your death and resurrection, bathe this child in light. Give him the new life of baptism and welcome him into your holy church. Through baptism and confirmation, make him your faithful follower and a witness to your gospel." Blessing the water in the baptismal font, the priest prays, "At the very dawn of creation, your spirit breathed on the waters, making them the wellspring of all holiness. The waters of the great flood, you made a sign of the waters of baptism that make an end of sin and a new beginning of goodness. To the waters of the Red Sea, you led Israel out of slavery to be an image of God's holy people set free from sin by baptism. In the waters of the Jordan, your son was baptized by John and anointed with the Spirit. And your son willed that water and blood should flow from his side as he hung upon the cross. After his resurrection, he told his disciples, 'Go out and teach all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit.' Father, look with love now upon your church and unseal for her the fountain of baptism. By the power of the Spirit, give to the water of this font the grace of your Son. You created man in your own likeness. Cleanse him from sin and a new birth to innocence by water and the Spirit. We ask you, Father, with your Son, to send the Holy Spirit upon the water of this font. May all who are buried with Christ in the death of baptism rise also with him to newness of life. For we ask you this through Christ, who is our Lord."
In doing so, you are accepting the serious responsibility of training him in the practice of the faith. It will be your duty to bring him up to keep God's commandments.
Baptism, then, is not simply a pretty ceremony carried out as a sort of family tradition. Baptism flows from a commitment to live in a life that is Christ-centered, to God our Father as Christ did, and to relate to all human beings as he did. Above all, it is a commitment to reveal God's kingdom here on earth as he did.
Paul Luke, "I baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
When we are baptized, we are immersed into who Christ is and into his mission here on earth, God's project. It is through Christ, with Christ, and in Christ that we bring our world back home to God, our Father. This is God's calling, not ours. What is ours is to fulfill Christ's mission.